Okay, so I got an interesting one here for you today. Today I'm going to get into this. This is the Movo Wireless microphone system. It's called the Movo Wireless Mini Duo. And basically it's a duo because there are two microphones in this one box. And this is for those of you that are looking to create a little bit of content, but you don't have these huge budgets. You don't want to spend $200 on the more professional microphones like the Rode or the DJIs. This one had a lot of good reviews. I wanted to check it out. It runs around $50 if you want to get the two microphones, and about $40 if you just want the one. Just to level set a little bit, right now I am recording on my iPhone 13 Pro, and I am recording just using the native microphone that's on the iPhone. And I'm doing that purposely so we can start to see a little bit of difference if we hook up the lav mic that I was using with the iPhone, and then when we hook up the Movo to the iPhone, I'll also do some testing with this Sony A6400. Again, we'll use just a native built-in microphone on the camera, which isn't very good, guys. There's no doubt about it. The microphones on the camera, just not that good. So you do need an external microphone. So we'll do that. And then we'll also use the more advanced comical microphone that I have been using on the Sony. Let's take a look at it. We'll compare the quality. We'll see which ones we like better, and we'll determine whether this is actually worth $50 for your content creation. So let's go ahead and get into it. We'll start with the unboxing. We'll see what's in the box. So then we'll hook it up and we'll start doing some sound checks. Here we go, guys. So there it is, guys. This is the Movo Wireless Mini Duo 2.4 gigahertz wireless microphone system. Now, I got the one that comes with the 3.5 millimeter jack because this is what I need for my Sony camera. They do have one that comes with the lightning port, so they do have one specifically for iOS. They have one for Android, and they have one for cameras. Lucky for me, I already have the adapter for it. This little gadget here that I can attach to connect it to my iPhone, so I can use it now for my iPhone or my camera. And so there we go. So let's go ahead and get in, open it a little bit. Let's see what's in the box. There's the two microphones. These, I'm sure, are the windscreens. Let's take a look at that. Yeah, we have little mini windscreens. All right, let's see what's in the pouch. So we open this sucker up. There's a power cord. I guess that's a charging cable. It's another charging cable. Three charging cables. And then, yes, yeah, so it comes with this little pouch, so it's portable. You take it with you where you need to go. Of course, here are some instructions, a little sticker, and barcode. If you want to go ahead and scan that, guys, you can go ahead and see if you can copy yourself one. All right, so let's take a look at this and try to make some sense out of this. So three charging cables. This is the transmitter. And it comes with the USB-C port. This is microphone number one. This is microphone number two. And then let's move that out of the way. And then we have the two windscreens. So the windscreens, okay, they come with this little, not sure if you can see it, they come with this little cut in the windscreen already. So the cut in the windscreen can just go right over top of the clip on the microphone, just like that there. Not that easy to get on there, though, that's for sure. Okay, so got that. So that's what it looks like with the microphone on. It doesn't look too big. I know some other microphones kind of like the DJI, there's like this big box. So this is a little bit more discreet. Here is the transmitter. So what I'm realizing here is that these need to be charged. Now, unfortunately, each one of these pieces need to be charged individually. So that's why there's three charging cables. I would love to see it where you could just plug them all in together and charge them all at once, because now you have to worry about not just carrying all of your pieces of the equipment, but you have to worry about making sure you have enough charging cables for all three of them if you want to charge them simultaneously. I'm sure there's something out there in the marketplace you could probably find where it'll combine the three and charge them, but as it is right now, this is what we got. So let's go ahead and get these plugged in and charged, and
get back into testing.
Okay, so we're all charged up. We have our three pieces of equipment here. Now, it's just me. I got the extra one just so if I'm doing some interviews with somebody or my wife and I are going out, we have the extra one. So we'll test that in a different environment just for the sake of testing it now. As I said in the beginning, right now you're listening to the native microphone on the iPhone. So this is the iPhone 13 Pro that I'm recording this on right now. This is the native microphone. We're gonna go ahead and get this connected and see what it sounds like once we connect the Movo. So here we go. Okay, so now we're connected to the Movo. I am actually using the wireless Movo right now. This is the piece that's in my hand. As you can see, it comes with a clip. So if you want to, you can kind of clip it on your shirt or whatever. I don't know. Let's test it out, see what it sounds like. I know it's a little annoying when it's there. I personally don't really like to have mics showing too often, but this is what it sounds like if I was to clip it onto my shirt. I'm talking to you. I'm standing about 5 feet from the camera. I don't know how much range this has. We'll take a look at the specs on that. But this is what it sounds like as I would typically use it. Let's go ahead and replace it with the corded lav mic that I have been using, and let's see if there's any difference in the sound. So I'll come back to you when I get that hooked up. Okay, so now I have the lav mic that I typically use. And again, I'm staying about 5 feet away from the phone. This is about the maximum range that I'm gonna get. This is a corded lav. You can see here I have the cord. It's a little bit of an older microphone. It's not one of the high-end lav mics, but it's been working for me. If you're just doing some simple social media content, some TikToks and things like that, it should be fine. But this is what it sounds like with the lav mic that I have been using that's attached to the cable. So I'm interested to see the difference in the sound when I go back and run all this, and I'll come back with some final thoughts. So that's it when you use it for the iPhone. So now we're gonna go ahead and test it in my Sony camera, which is one of the main reasons why I got it, because the built-in microphone on the Sony is just not that good at all. And then let's see how that goes. Pretty simple, like I said, I got the 3.5 millimeter jack, so that just plugs directly into the camera. They're already paired up. All right, so here we go. This is me with the Sony A6400, and I am attached to the audio through the Movo wireless microphone. This is just your basic selfie style type of video, so just arm length away. Let's see what it sounds like in this environment. We'll do a sound check, 1, 2. Tell me what you think this sounds like coming through on the Movo. Now, this is without any sound design or anything here in the video. This is what it sounds like connected to the Sony A6400 through the Movo. Okay. So this is me on the Sony A6400 with my Comica microphone that I would typically use in a more controlled environment. I find that this rig is a little too big typically for me to go out vlogging. If I want a real professional vlog with the whole setup, if I'm doing maybe some client work or something, I would attach it, but just, run and gun type of shooting, That's not it. It's just way too much. It's way too big of a contraption. But this is what it sounds like connected to the Comica mic. Let's get these loaded in. Let's do a sound check. I am about to head out, guys. I am going to be going out running some errands. I'm going to take you with me to Walmart, because what I want to do is I want to try the microphone when in a more outside environment. Let's test for noise reduction, see how bad the wind may be, and see how much range it may actually be able to give us. So we'll do that, and then we'll come back and let's go ahead and compare these, and you guys can tell me what you think. Here we go. Alright guys, so I know this seems random, this is not random. I am out doing some runs. My babes, my darling wife, she loves a particular type of eggnog. You can usually find it around Christmas time. So I made a special stop here at ABC Spirits and decided to try to see if I can find it for her. We're gonna go in, take a look to see whether we can find that. But I'm here, I am standing at least 10 feet away. I wanted to see what kind of range this thing has as I walk around a little bit. To see what kind you pick up. The wind is, we have a little bit of wind going on too, so it's a good time to see whether or not you can actually hear that wind. It's a nice breeze coming through. I wanted to get this done before it got too dark outside. I don't want to be standing in random parking lots in the dark, obviously, right? So this is what it's like. I'm facing the camera. Not sure how well you can hear it. I'll be anxious to see how that goes. I'm getting pretty good levels though on my viewfinder. If I turn around and I walk the other way, we can see how far we can actually go with this. So I'll be curious to see how far this is going to pick up any type of sound. Here I am. I'm already at the other side of the parking lot. I would say it's a good, 30 feet or so. So we'll see what kind of range it has. I'm anxious to see how it sounds here in this environment. I'm going to go ahead inside and see what we can find. And I'll be back. Not exactly what we wanted. All we need is love. All we need is love. It's eggnog, so it's March. What are you going to do? Okay, so it's been about 24 hours now since I unboxed this Movo Wireless Mini Duo system. And I have some thoughts I want to share, my final thoughts on some of the pros and some of the cons. My overall thoughts for the price, $50, it's a good buy. For $50, you get the receiver and you get two microphones. And the receiver that I got is for a 3.5 millimeter jack, but they do have them for iPhone and Android as well. Great accessory to have if you're doing some basic social media content, like there's Instagram Reels, there's TikTok, some YouTube Shorts, just some basic quick social media content. I think the value is pretty good. The range seemed pretty good. I mean, I did about 30 to 40 feet away when I was outside in that environment, and it worked pretty well for you. You can see I am using it right now, recording it to my Sony A6400, and it seems to be working pretty fine. I'll let you be the judge for yourself. Typically for these type of videos, I would use the boom mic or I would use my Elgato mic, but just to stay true, since this is a review on the Movo, figure I'll end the video on the actual microphone itself, right? It makes sense. So you can be the judge of that. Those are some of the pros, you know, for the price. Gives you a good deal, gives you pretty decent quality. It is easy to use. For two microphones for $50, you really can't beat it. Now, I do have some cons. The first con has to be this here. Three charging cables. And it has three charging cables because each one of the devices has its own cable. All three of those take separate charges. It would have been nice for it to come with some way to charge all three of them at once, because I don't know about you, but it's oftentimes very difficult to find three open outlets to charge all these things at once. So the fact that you have to charge all three of them separately, that poses a bit of a problem, which is why some of the more higher end microphones will have those charging cases where you can put it all together and just use one charge for it. That would have been a great idea. It does come with this pouch for you to carry, to make it easy for you to bring along with you. Great, but it doesn't help with the charging at all, does it? Right. So that's it. The other thing that I had a problem with this particular device is that I like the microphones because they're small. They're kind of compact. You can see it's clipped on my collar. It's pretty inconspicuous. I mean, you know, it is what it is. You know, it's a microphone. You know it's there, but it's not too big and bulky, right? Like a big old pager on my neck or something. But these here come with the windscreens, and I love the fact that it comes with the windscreens. These windscreens are kind of hard to put onto the microphone initially, and maybe it's just because they're new and over time they'll loosen up. But there's also, although they're hard to put on, they're easy to come off. And so I'm scared that as you walk around, if you're not paying attention, these things are easy to fall off and get lost, and then you'll have to replace them. So those are two of the cons. The third con, which is a pretty major one and pretty serious, I did try two microphones. My wife and I tried it in different environments, and both microphones record onto one single track. Now, for your basic stuff, not so much of an issue, but if you're looking to do some more polished commercial type of work where you want to separate out the audio and have separate tracks to do its own sound design, not the ideal situation for that. So, final recommendation. $50 is a great deal if you're just looking at it for your basic social media content. Like I said, your Instagram Reels, your TikToks, your YouTube Shorts. If you're looking to do any client work, any professional projects, I would recommend
upgrading to one of the more professional mics, you know, when you have the budget to do it. This will hold you off until then, but once you get that extra money, it would be helpful to go ahead and upgrade. So there you go. Those are my thoughts on the Movo Wireless Mini Duo. That's the box here. I have all the links in the description below to the Movo, to the Comico mic that I tested, and the cord lavalier mic that I tested earlier in the video as well. If this video helped you at all, if you found any value in it, make sure you smash that like button for me to feed the algorithm. If this is the type of content that you like, make sure you subscribe to this channel so we can share some more tips and tricks on how you can upskill and improve your life and your business in this digital economy. I am your boy, Paul. As always, it's been a pleasure sharing my journey with you, and I hope to see you along yours. Take care.